When you're busy in the lab, you don't always have time to make new LB-agar plates containing every antibiotic you need. Luckily, there is a relatively quick way to add antibiotic to your plates in a pinch. In this video, we'll walk you through the Over-Agar Antibiotic Plating method for selection of transformed E. coli. In this method, we pipette the antibiotic we need onto a pre-poured LB-agar plate, spread it, and let it sit so the antibiotic can diffuse throughout the plate. While we'll specifically focus on selection with carbamazepine in this video, this method can be adapted for any antibiotic once you've determined the optimum concentration of antibiotic to add to your plates via a selection curve. Please see our protocol page for a detailed description of how to make your own selection curve. Before we add the antibiotic to our plates, we must first gather all of the required materials. These include 6-centimeter LB-agar plates without antibiotic, a concentrated stock solution of carbamazepine in sterile water, pipette tips for both pipetting and spreading, and E. coli transformed with a plasmid containing the carbamazepine resistance gene. Before plating, we must prepare our antibiotic at the appropriate concentration. We keep sterile stocks of carbamazepine in water at 100 milligrams per milliliter. To prepare 4 milligrams per milliliter carbamazepine in LB, we simply dilute 1 to 25 into the required amount of LB. For example, if we were making 10 plates, we would need 150 microliters per plate, equaling 1.5 milliliters of LB. It is always good to make a little more than we need for our exact number of plates, so we'll make 2 milliliters of LB with carbamazepine at 4 milligrams per milliliter. With a stock solution of 100 milligram per milliliter carbamazepine, we simply dilute 80 microliters of this stock solution into 1,920 microliters of LB for a total of 2 milliliters. This LB carbamazepine solution will have a concentration of 4 milligrams per milliliter. Now that we have our 4 milligram per milliliter LB carbamazepine solution, we need to add it to our plates. To do so, we retrieve our pre-poured LB plates from the cold room and use a 200 microliter pipette to add 150 microliters of the LB carbamazepine solution to the top of the plate next to an open flame. Now we must spread the antibiotic over the plate. You could do this with a sterile glass spreader, but we find that it is easier and faster to use a pipette tip. Gently bend the pipette tip into an L shape. Then, touch the bottom of the L to the plate and gently swab the pooled antibiotic over the entire surface of the plate. Warning! Warning! Be careful not to dig into the plate! With the antibiotic spread thoroughly, we now incubate the plate for 30 minutes at room temperature with the lid on to allow the antibiotic to more completely absorb into the agar. When 30 minutes is up, we're ready to spread the bacteria onto the plate. To do so, we use the same technique we used to spread the antibiotic. Here, we plate 50 microliters of the transformed E. coli, bend our pipette tip, and spread the E. coli over the entire surface of the plate using the bent tip, being careful not to dig into the plate. Now we place the plate at 37 degrees Celsius for 18 hours to allow the antibiotic-resistant E. coli to grow. After 18 hours, we observe our plates to make sure the transformation was successful. If we use the appropriate concentration of antibiotic, we should see many individual colonies. If we use too little antibiotic, we should see a lawn of bacteria, many of which are not transformed. We cannot use bacteria from this plate. If we use too much antibiotic, we'll see little to no bacterial growth. When you are first determining the concentration of antibiotic to use for the Over-Agar method, you should also spread your transformants on a control plate that has the appropriate amount of in-agar antibiotic. This will tell you if you use too much antibiotic or if the transformation just didn't work. Please note that it is possible to use this method to add multiple antibiotics to a single plate, but you should always determine the appropriate concentration of each antibiotic empirically first. The concentration required will be different for each antibiotic. Once we get individual colonies, we can pick or restreak these for later experiments. Good luck! Thank you for watching AdGene's Over-Agar Antibiotic Protocol video. Please browse our other videos for more lab techniques as well as career advice and tips on how to best use AdGene's resources. Leave a comment below to let us know what videos you'd like to see in the future or to tell us how we can improve. AdGene, a better way to share science.